When you look at the history of textiles or garments, 100 years ago or 200 years ago, garments used to be highly valued. They were expensive. So garments were really a product that you cherished and kept for a long time. In the last 10 years, garments and fashion items have become sort of a consumable item.
The textile industry must change because it uses a lot of plastics in a way that is not sustainable. That means we use resources that are non-renewable, we are not using the plastics after they have been used, and as a consequence we have a negative impact on the environment and on the climate in general.
My name is Matthias Fuchs. I'm the Chief Marketing Officer of OceanSafe. OceanSafe is a company that is on a mission to revolutionize the textile industry. We help brands and retailers develop fully circular, biodegradable textiles. We have biodegradable synthetic fibers, which are developed by us. We have a fully certified supply chain, which we provide to our customers, our retailers and brands, and they manufacture their circular products there.
Mein Name ist Manuel Schweitzer. Ich bin der Gründer und der CEO von OceanSafe. Ich bin seit über 40 Jahren im Bereich von Textilien unterwegs und man könnte zusammenfassen, Textilien sind mein Leben. Die Textilindustrie ist nur ein Part, der ändern muss. Alles, was in die Natur kommen kann, muss für sicher sein für den biologischen Kreislauf. 80% der verlorenen Erde, das dürften ca. 25 Milliarden Tonnen Erde sein jedes Jahr, die wir verlieren, muss ersetzt werden und somit muss alles, was in die Natur kommt, wieder Erde werden.
Also ist das Ziel von OceanSafe, eine Baumwolle, was eine sensationelle Phase ist, im Labor nachzubauen. Und diese Phase hat dieselben Eigenschaften, aber sie kann skaliert werden und hat nicht den Verbrauch der ganzen Ressourcen, wie man eine Baumwolle für eine Baumwolle einsetzen muss.
We help our customers develop fully circular end products. These end products must be according to the OceanSafe standards. And these are that the end product is fully circular, it's biodegradable, it's manufactured completely without any toxins. We are not a producer ourselves, so we use partner factories where products are being manufactured. But right now, the product lines that we collaborate with are bed sheets, terry towels, bathrobes, and interior fabrics. Our model, our fibers, and our entire concept that we have is made for highly industrially scaled solutions. That is basically our challenge, is the transition from a great concept, from a great philosophy, from great values and standards to an implemented industrial standard. But that's our journey.
There are 5 trillion pieces of plastic contaminate the global ocean surface. And what we do know, at least not by mass, but in number terms, the vast majority of those particles are microplastics. The textiles industry does contribute to the microplastics problem. And that's because, at least for woven textiles, they wear and tear during use. So for example, walking on a carpet, or just us sitting and moving in these clothes, or when we wash clothes, all that mechanical stress does cause it to fragment. So textiles can emit plastic microfibers to the environment.
The plastics that are mostly being used today are non-degradable. That means they last a very long time in the oceans. It is important now to an eco-design that there is a producer responsibility for the product that they are producing. Making biodegradable fibers or compostable fibers, the process is more or less the same as synthetic fibers. You can get the chemicals and you can synthesize these bio-based products. These bio-based products can be made biodegradable, but you can also have the plastics that nature already made. And that means proteins, carbohydrates. These are the molecules, the polymers essentially, that are already available in nature and are also bio-based and biodegradable.
10% of the oil and gas industry goes into plastic, and a lot of that more systemic, deep-rooted issue in consumerism, if we can curb that, that's going to have lots of positive repercussions for lots of other issues that we face as a population.
Ob es schnell genug geht in der Textilindustrie, das wird sich zeigen. Auf jeden Fall ist jetzt Bewegung drin. Eine von beiden wird gewinnen. Ich setze ganz klar auf die Kreislaufwirtschaft. Ob sich im Moment gerade was ändert im Bewusstsein der Textilkonsumenten? Ja, glaube ich ganz fest. Wobei, die Moral war noch nie eine Stärke des Menschen. Also, es gibt nur eine Lösung. Unsere Textilien müssen günstiger sein, besser sein, schöner sein. Und dann haben wir überzeugende Argumente. Weil gut sind sie.
At the end of the day, we are idealistic people and we do want to change the world a little bit, yes. Our dream would be to change the world dramatically.